The Vietnam War was a controversial war. The war began when Eisenhower deployed military assistance in 1955. America believed that the communist government shouldn't rule Vietnam and U.S. troops could help.
The Vietnam War was a result of the Cold War. The Cold War was to stop the spread of communism. The war was between the United States and their allies versus the Soviet Union and their allies that believed in communism. This all happened after World War II for about 50 years and all led to the Vietnam War.
Not all Americans were in support of entering the war. This was due to issues involving the draft and what the purpose of our involvement with Vietnam was. Many people believed it was not our war to fight. A common reputation that the United States got was the world police. This is so because our army is strong, we believe in democracy, peace, and equality.
With the draft being in effect, this caused money problems for young Americans, primarily college students. These students were upset that they had to go against their beliefs of anti-war to serve in Vietnam. The result of the draft were students fleeing to Canada, Mexico, and other parts of the country to avoid draft officers.
One event that blew up the young American protests was the Kent State shootings. This occurred on May 4, 1970. After students were shot at a protest, other schools went on strike and joined larger protests, thus including my father, Adam Kretowicz. Adam Kretowicz was one of 9 children. He grew up in Red Bank, New Jersey. As the second oldest child, it was his job to look after his younger siblings. He was the only boy until Uncle Michael was born years later. Adam attended an all-Catholic high school where he played varsity tennis and later proceeded to attend Marquette University at Wisconsin. At Marquette, my dad expressed his views of being a hardcore Democrat. He was also very active in politics. When Adam heard of the Vietnam War and the problems that occurred with it, he was intent on protesting.
So, were you involved in any large protests against the war?
Probably the largest protest ever against the war.
Which protest?
In Chicago in 1968 at the National Democratic Convention.
Oh, really? Tell me about it. What happened?
You'd have to be there to believe. It's like being in a war. You're marching with thousands of youths, students.
Mostly college students.
But some conscientious elder people. And some conscientious high school students across the board, but I would say the general age group was probably 18 to 25.
Okay, so was this protest a peaceful protest, or
well, it tried
were there
to
problems?
Be, oh, there were major problems. It tried
what
to be.
What happened?
What happened? As we were marching, we had a permit for some time and some places we could march. And there were more people came than expected.
Okay.
And so we started marching from the north side of Chicago, heading toward the convention center on Lake Michigan, and literally converging on what's called Grant Park. Tens of, if not hundreds of thousands of peace movements, and then all of a sudden, not all of a sudden, but you could see them lined up on horses.
Okay.
Were armed police officers with guards like this, like shields, helmets.
Police officers or state government, state troopers?
At the time, I didn't know. I just know they,
yeah,
they
so
were
it was just scary.
They were military, they were
right.
Police. There were approximately 500 of them.
Oh, wow. So what happened?
There were approximately 1,000 police cars, all with 3 other police officers in the car besides the driver with guns that were shot, rubber bullets like this, that when it hit you, it wouldn't kill you, but it would break your leg or break your arm. There's others who came in who shot tear gas. And so before you know it, the place was in utter disarray, chaos, arrests, Molotov cocktails. The place smelled.
What happened to you personally and your friends?
Well, my friend who was right next to me at the time was a man named Benjamin Elliott. And we both had been living in Chicago at the time. He got his head smashed in by a police officer on a horse.
Smashed in where?
Right inside here.
And what, was he okay?
No, he cracked and started to bleed, and he fell right to the ground. And then tear gas was running, then I was coughing, then I fell to the ground with him, got him onto my shoulders, and dragged him back to We actually went back to a gas station where I made a phone call, and someone picked us up in 10 minutes, we went to the hospital.
Oh, wow.
The other side of the war was in Vietnam, where the physical fighting was taking place. This is where brave troops fought for justice for the Vietnamese. One man that was included in this was Michael McGuire. My grandfather was born in Waltham, Mass. On December 26, 1948, to his mother Louise McGuire and his father Red. He's the oldest of three siblings. As a young boy, he enjoyed taking walks with his father and being in the outdoors. Later on, he went to Waltham High School. He graduated with the class of 1964. This is when he met his high school sweetheart and soulmate, Trisha Palmer. My grandpa's dad served in World War II, which influenced my grandfather to also serve for his country. Michael McGuire voluntarily joined the Vietnam War with two friends from high school. These friends were Tom and John. Together, all three of them risked their lives to defend the lives of the Vietnamese. While fighting in the war, he would send money and letters home to his family to aid them while he was gone. The letters were to give them something to remember him by while he was gone. Enclosed in the letters were directions as to what the money should be used for besides necessities. For example, gifts for his brother and sister.